Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I appreciate you calling up House Resolution 653, which recognizes the 100th anniversary of the awarding of Old Economy Village to the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. The story of Old Economy Village starts similarly to the tale of other early Americans. In 1803, a group of German immigrants migrated from the city-state of Wurttemberg to Pennsylvania in search of religious tolerance. These immigrants, who followed the preaching of Johann George Rapp and dubbed themselves harmonists, established three entrepreneurial-based communities, including Harmony, Pennsylvania, New Harmony, Indiana, and what was known at the time simply as Economy, which was located where Ambridge, my hometown, now stands in Beaver County. The soil found at Economy was rich for farming, and the location was ideal for shipping their products to markets on the Ohio and Mississippi rivers and to the west in the newly settled areas of the frontier. The Harmonists founded their settlements initially as an agricultural-based community, but quickly industrialized by adding textile and grist mills to their communities. The Harmonists later turned to investing and enjoyed a period of relative prosperity until the 1890s. Now, the website for Old Economy Village gives details of how the utopian society was planned for efficiency. After 20 years in the United States and the experience of building and operating two other communities, Harmony and New Harmony, the society's leaders had a clear understanding of the community needs. The church and the houses of George Rapp and his adopted son Frederick were located at the center of town. Business locations included a store and post office, mechanics building and wine cellar, warehouse and granary. The feast hall used for communal dinners and concerts with the Natural Museum History on the first floor was located in the center of town. Positioned directly around the center were members' houses, 80 of which survive to this day, including my legislative office and original Harmonist home. At the outer edges of the community were livestock, barns and stables, a tannery, textile mills, blacksmith shop, and other buildings. Now, while the religious aspects of the society held little importance for the nation's political leaders, its success in placing the agriculturalists beside the industrialists did arouse interest. Frederick Rapp was recognized as the driving force behind Harmony Society's business ventures. His insights were valued to the extent that in 1828, Rapp, who corresponded with political leaders both in Harrisburg and Washington, D.C., was subpoenaed to testify before the United States Congress. However, his health prevented him from testifying in person. The society's financial successes and self-sufficiency stirred the interest of economists and social reformers in the United States and Europe. Among Economy's many important visitors was prominent German economist Frederick List, who visited Economy in 1825 and observed the community at work. That same year, British social reformer Frances Wright stayed for several days, seeking guidance from Frederick Rapp as she planned a community for freed slaves in Tennessee. German royals also visited, as did President Zachary Taylor while he was in office. In 1885, Old Economy trustee Jonathan Lentz promised to transfer the community's assets to the Commonwealth if the Messiah did not return before the last Harmonist died. Ultimately, 6 acres of Economy and associated buildings became the property of Pennsylvania in 1916. In 1917, the Harmony Society Historical Association was founded and began providing historic tours to the public. In 1919, the association entered into the contract with the Commonwealth, which took over the property and officially opened it to the public May 26, 1921. Old Economy Village is now designated as both a National Historic Landmark and is also listed on the National Register of Historic Places. Even National Geographic has highlighted Old Economy as a location of historical importance. Now, throughout the years, Old Economy Village has undergone several extensive restorations to ensure this historical landmark is preserved for at least another 100 years. As you all know, it takes more than restoration efforts to ensure a landmark will be open for generations to come. It also takes funds and a commitment from the community. In fact, during my first term in 2009, the threat of budget cuts led to talks that cuts would cause Old Economy to close. Through the efforts of myself, Senator Vogel, my colleagues in the House, namely Representative Gibbons, Marshall, and Christiana, we did everything in our power to ensure that didn't happen. In fact, the outpouring of support from the community was a testament for the need to ensure this important historical site would not be mothballed. And we worked with the Rendell administration, later the Corbett administration, Pennsylvania Historical Museum Commission, the Friends of Old Economy, to ensure that Old Economy would continue to offer its unique historical perspective for years to come. Finally, I'm proud to say that it remains a favorite destination for tourists and locals alike who are interested in learning more about this fascinating chapter in the Commonwealth's history. I encourage all of you here today to come out to Beaver County and visit this truly unique historical landmark. I'd be happy to give you a tour. Once again, I'd like to thank you for bringing this resolution up, and I ask for unanimous support. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.